Hello friends, today's topic in the combinational circuit is decoder expansion. Let's understand in detail about how the decoder expansions work. So here is the first point. What is a decoder expansion? So decoder expansion, as the name simplifies, is nothing but expanding the use case of the decoder. So I have started this entire slide by considering one scenario. Like, let's suppose you need 6x8 line decoder. You are in need that you need such kind of decoder. This particular size is required, right? And it is not available to you at that particular moment. So if you have 4x16 lines decoders available, then what you can do is you can combine them together, because this is what, 64 lines. So this are 16 in number outputs. So if 16 is multiplied by 4, 16 4s are 64, right? So I think I can easily generate the result of 64 outputs by using the 4x16 input. So how 16 line decoder. So how many exactly 4x16 line decoders would be required? I could say it is 4 decoders would be required. Okay. So idea is, this particular problem can easily be resolved when we will combine some small size of decoders which are available to us to make the required output. So this procedure of expanding the lower size decoders in order to generate the output of large decoder, this is what we refer to as a decoder expansion. So decoders can be expanded by combining two or more decoders with enable input. So here in the decoder expansion topic, we will understood that how enable is helping us in providing various solutions to our problems. Okay. So in the decoder expansion, enable plays a vital role. So we will understand how the enable is helping us to in the expansion of the decoder in next slide. So in this particular scenario, we are considering a one use case. The use case is, I need to design a 3x8 line decoder by combining two 2x4 decoders. So guys, whenever you will get any question on the topic of decoder expansion, you would always be provided with some hints within the question. Hints like, here the point mentioned is two 2x4 decoders are required, right? So it means that in order to generate 3x8 decoder, I am assuming that I need to work with two 2x4 decoders. Otherwise, the logic is very much clear. We always have to consider the output part, because inputs I can arrange by myself. Let's suppose I need 2x4 decoders I am having. I want to generate such kind of result. First of all, I will start with the output part. The output is like, availability is of 4 outputs, right? So required are 8 outputs. So as simple as it is, 4 if multiplied with 2. So what I am going to get? 4 2s are 8, right? So definitely, if I will be using 2x4 size of decoders, then ultimately the output requirement will get fulfilled, right? So this is how we will always think about how we can do the decoder expansion, by looking at the size of output required and the size of outputs available with us. So with this, the first step would be determining the outputs. Right. So output I have determined. Now I need 8 output values. So from 4 easily I can design that. So what I did, I use 2 decoders. Now the next part is, so this is like D0, D1, D2, D3. So what I did is, for my convenience only, I considered that, okay, D4, D5, D6 and D7 are the results been generated by this decoder. Now what is the next point? Now from the last, we will move towards the first, means from the output, now we have to arrange the appropriate inputs. So what we are having, again, we are having 2 cross 4 means 2 inputs are required. So here also 2 inputs are required. So what I will do is these 2 inputs being A0 and A1, I will provide them common to both, right? This is also getting A0, this is also A1, here is also A0 and A1, right? So the next thing is that how I would be able to generate the 3 inputs within a 2 cross 4 decoder. So again, I know that within the decoder, I can provide an extra input in the form of enable, right? So this enable, how it is going to work is, I will take another input A2, I will apply inverter in between, right? Inverted gate, so that at any point of time, whatsoever will be its output value, like if it is 000. So how I am going to work, at any point of time, this A2 will be responsible for determining whether this decoder is functioning or this decoder is functioning. Like if this value of A2 is 0, so its inverter will become 1 here. So this is again 0, this is again 0, this is 1. So same case, A0 and A1 is 0, 0 in this case, but if inverter is if I am getting directly the A0 value, so this 0 is flowing here, 0, 0, 0. So we know that there is a rule within the decoder, enable should always be equals to 1. Only then you would be able to make the decoder function. So this particular, you could say that idea I will use in order to determine the outputs, right? So it means that this decoder is not going to provide me any output. So the outputs would always remain 0, 0, 0. So again, from here, whichever the value I have set for this 0, 0, 0, let's suppose I said for 0, 0, the decoder 1 will be active, rest all will be 0. So this is how the output will be depicted. Now, if you have any doubt in understanding what I am meaning by the term this D0, D1, D2, D3 and all these, and how this 0, 0, 0 and this 1 is coming here, then please refer to the previous session. Previous session where I have explained you about what is a decoder and how does the decoder functions. Okay, so go to the previous session, have a clear idea about how the decoder is able to generate the output. Now the next point in this regard is, whenever you will get a question related to decoder expansion, now how you will work in that case is, you will always use block diagrams. You need not to draw the logic circuit diagram. So only the block diagram will be preferred in that case. So this was very easy topic in the case of decoder expansion, like how we can generate the large size of decoder by just combining these the small size of decoders. Now again, the idea is that this is the entire four step process. First is, you have to start with the output, how many outputs are required. Okay, so then you will be trying to arrange the input values. Then you need to work, configure that, you need to consider that how the enable is working in your this decoder expansion case, right? Then after that is, always we will be carrying or working with the block diagrams within the decoder expansion. So one problem I have stated here, so that we can have a better clarity about how we can how we can get the questions within the exam. So the question could be something like this. Like what is, construct a 5 to 32 line decoder with the 4 3 to 8 line decoders and with enable, an extra enable is required here, and 1 2 to 4 line decoder. So try to understand the concept here. So definitely, as I was saying, you always have to refer to the question. Some hints will be given within the question, like how you are going to work with the decoder and expansion parts. Along with that, you would also be provided with certain conditions, right? Like how you have to use the things. Like here it is directly been mentioned, you have to use four decoders with size 3 cross 8 will be used. Along with that, one enable is required. This is what is been asked here. and one decoder whose size should be 2x4 will be used, right? So this is how they have given me the question. Now the idea is what I am looking for, what is my desire, what I actually have to generate. I have to generate a 5x32 line decoder. This size I need to build up, right? So how could I start or think about the things? Again, as I was saying, I was explaining you earlier, we will start with the output part. How much, what is the size of output required? 32, okay. So how many, what is the biggest size available within this condition? 8. So 8, if I multiply it with 4, will directly give me 32. 8 fours are 32, definitely. So it means that this condition of 4, even if it is not been provided within the question, I need to know how I can determine how many 3 to 8 lines decoders are required. So it is directly been given that I will be using 4 decoders of size 3x8, and along with that I will be providing one enable, and then यहाँ पे जो इनपुट है हाउ इट आई एम गोइंग टू गेट. सो अगेन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर डिकोडर हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गेट द आउटपुट इज आई विल बी एडिंग अ 2x4 काइंड ऑफ डिकोडर हियर, देन फ्रॉम देयर ओनली आई विल गो हियर. सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड हाउ व्हाट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग हियर इन थ्रेटिकल मैनर. सो दिस इज द आउटपुट, दिस इज हाउ दिस इंटायर क्वेश्चन विल बी सॉल्व. ओके, सो लेट्स अगेन लुक एट दिस क्वेश्चन. So the requirement was, again I am writing here, I was looking for 4 3 to 8 size decoders, and there was a one decoder which could be of size 2x4. So ultimately what I was looking for was, I was looking for a 5 to 32 line decoder. So this was appropriate thing. So I, as I tell you, question says 4 were now 3x8, so I did that, 1 2 3 and 4, right? So reason behind these 4 decoders of size this 3x8 is nothing but because I need to depict the results 32 as an output. So again I can easily calculate 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 would be nothing but 32. So starting from 0 till 31 I am getting all the 32 outputs. Now my next agenda is, after determining the output, so I will be now looking for the input part, how to generate the inputs. So to this 3x8, again, we will start from here and we will move towards that. So first step is done. So let's go and look for these input values. So definitely 3 inputs are required. So these 3 inputs being in the form of A0, A1 and A2, that will remain common to all these 3x8 line decoders. Okay. So this is A0, this is A1 and this is A2. But along with that, within the question statement, it was also mentioned that these decoders should also have enable attached to them. This was again a condition. So in order to get an enable, so what I will do is, I will provide the enable from the output of this 2x4 decoder, because 2x4 should also be used, right? So main ko kya karungi? 3 inputs are coming from here. 2 I will provide to this first decoder in the form of A3 and A4. According to these A3 and A4, like A3 and A4 is there. It could be having the value like 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Accordingly, any particular either 0, 1, 2 or 3 value will get activated. Like it is, let's suppose D0, it is D1, or I am just changing the name to T0. T1, T2 or T3, right? So 1, 1, 1, 1 I will get in a diagonal basis. So depending upon how I am generating the output, designing the truth table, right? So accordingly, whenever the value is 0, 0, let's suppose, this value will become active as a 1, this enable is active. So all the other values are 0, 0, 0. So the idea is that if I look here, number of inputs now are becoming 5, number of outputs are becoming 32. So definitely this will lead me for the required kind of expanded version of decoders which has been generated from 3 cross 8 and 2 cross 4 decoders, right? So we know that at any single point of time, any one decoder should work. So whenever the E values are 0, 0, 0 in this case, it means I am going to get all these decoders will provide me, the output will be 0, 0, 0. Only one input will be coming, right? Let's suppose for D naught, I am going to get 1, and D1 to D7, the output will be 0. Same is the case. Let's suppose the value of this is 0, 1. So it means that in case of 0, 1, what I will get is, I'm just trying to demonstrate it in a much better way. So in case of 0, 1 coming here, so it means that now this value will remain 0, this will remain 1, rest all will 0. So this enable is now equals to 0, this enable is active, this is again 0, this is again 0. It means the resultant is not now going to come from this particular second number of decoder. So depending upon whatsoever the inputs are coming here, whether it is 0, 0, 0 or it is something else, accordingly, it will be depicting the result from this particular decoder. So this is how we are able to control, or we are able to control the all the decoders, and this is how the entire functionality of 5 to 32 size of decoder can be generated. As simple as it is. So the next case is about encoders. So let's understand about what are the encoders, because encoders also play a very important role. So let's understand the concept of encoders. Encoders are nothing but again the combinational circuits. So this is the first point we should always know, under which category of the digital circuits any particular electronic component falls. So these are the combinational circuits that performs the inverse operation of that of the decoder. So let's recall the decoder first. What was the decoder and how the decoder was functioning? Decoder was like, in case of input, it was taking n number of input values. So in case of output, a maximum of 2 raised to power n outputs used to come. This was how decoders function. Now what is happening in case of encoder? Encoder is doing the inverse operation of that of decoder. So it means that inverse means the opposite value. In case of encoder, what is happening is the number of inputs are now equals to 2 cross 1. These are the input values, right? And number of outputs are now equals to n. So means if I used to say that the size of decoder is 2 cross 4 for any reason, like for n being 2, so I know that for 2 raised to power 2 will yield the result 4. So the size of decoder will be 2 cross 4. But in case of encoder, how I could write the same thing? I could write it like 4 cross 2 size of encoder. So don't get confused. It is working exactly the inverse of, opposite of what we are getting in the decoder. So the output lines generate the binary code corresponding to input value, right? So whatsoever is the input being given, so accordingly the output will be provided. So the truth table and the logic circuit diagram of an octal to binary. Octal means nothing but 2 raised to power 2 raised to power 3 to 3. Octal to binary number will be generated, means 8 to 8 cross 3 line decoder is shown in the next slide. So let's understand that, how the decoders function and what is the logic circuit diagram of an encoder. So here is the case. As I said earlier, encoders are represented like this, right? So it is nothing but 2 cross 3 cross 3 value, 2 raised to power n to n value. So idea is, it is exactly inverse of decoder. So what I did, so how I was designing the truth table in case of decoder, this used to be in this side, this used to be in this side. So now what is happening? These D0 to D7 are nothing but the input values, and these A0, A1, A2 are nothing but the output values, okay? So we know the concept. At any point of time, only one value will be active. So accordingly, some data will be generated in the form of output. Now my point is, how to design the logic circuit diagram? So if I have to look for logic circuit diagram, I have to understand how the output is generated again. So number of outputs are three. So I have provided that, okay, three outputs would be required in the form of A0, A1 and A2. And number of inputs are coming like D0, 2, so on up to D7, right? So these all are required. So if I look here to A0, when there is a possibility that this 8 cross 3 encoder is going to generate the output, the possibility are only these. So I will have to check when, in which particular decoder value is active in this case. So in this case of A0, what I am having is A0 when D1 is active, D1 is active plus when D3 is active, when D5 is active, and when D7 is active. So what I did is I just did the OR of that. The reason being, whenever I will be designing the logic circuit diagram, I know that if either of this value is equals to 1 and rest all are 0, always the A0 value is going to come to be equals to 1. Same is the case of A1. So A1 is coming like D2, then D3, then D6 and D7. D2, D3, D6 and D7. Same is for this A2 case, right? We can determine that. Now what will happen is we will provide all the input lines, and as I know that when A0 will depict the result, when I will add D1 along with D3, along with D5, along with D7, right? So this is how it is connected. D1, then it is D3 coming, then it is D5 which is coming, and the last is the D7, right? Same is the case for A1 also. A1 is providing me the output when D2, D3, D6 and D7 is coming. Same is for the last A2. It is like D4, D5, D6 and D7. The only point to remember in case of encoder is that always we are going to work with the OR gate. Okay, so the combinational circuit or the logic circuit diagram is been designed using the OR gates, because we will just add these. Either of this value should be equals to 1 in order that I want the output to be coming from this, either of these output values, A0, A1 or A2. So guys, with this I have explained the decoder expansion, and I had tried to cover the encoders at my level best. If you have any doubts, you can ping me. Otherwise, thank you so much for this session.